There is a new breakthrough and improvement in solid-state batteries that are going to be used in electric vehicles. Researchers improve ionic conductivity in solid-state batteries, and in this report, I'm going to tell you the details of that. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle battery news, and also ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage, and also please give us thumbs up if you find this report helpful. So Alex Smith reports in Azo Materials saying, along with the increasing demand for electric vehicles, all solid-state batteries have gained higher attention. All solid-state batteries are next-generation batteries that would be alternatives for lithium-ion batteries, which are inherently hazardous owing to their explosive nature. Now, when in this report I say all solid-state batteries, I don't mean all batteries, but like all solid-state batteries. That means solid-state batteries that are all-inclusive solid-state batteries, not partially solid. So the popularization of electric vehicles is right now kind of hampered by the low ionic conductivity of solid-state polymer electrolytes, or the low chemical stability of solid-state sulfide electrolytes. Scientists from POSTECH created a polymer electrolyte without a dead zone, which reduces ion transport, speeding up the commercialization of all solid-state batteries. Now, do you understand why this is very important news? Because this is yet another big step toward commercialization of solid-state batteries. Researchers headed by Professor Moon Jong Park and PhD candidate Jaemin Min of POSTECH's Department of Chemistry, with Professor Chang Yu Sun's research group from the Division of Advanced Materials Science, created a novel block copolymer electrolyte that controls the structure through electrostatic interactions. This seems a little bit complicated, but what they have done, they have created a block that controls the structure and not allowing dead zones. This study is garnered attention as it fundamentally resolves the problem of lowered mobility of ions in the dead zone that unavoidably exists in traditional two-dimensional morphologies. The outcomes of this study were published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Science of the United States of America and an authoritative journal in the area of energy and chemistry. A major majority of the energy storage devices still use lithium-ion batteries. In a lithium-ion battery, ions are moved by a liquid electrolyte. Even minor damage can leak into the electrolyte, resulting in a fire or explosion, and so are considered to be unstable. This is why the electric vehicle industry in many areas is trying to move to solid-state batteries. QuantumScape is doing its research on solid-state batteries. Toyota apparently has about 1,000 solid-state battery patents, and other companies are as well trying to look into solid-state batteries. Tesla seems to be quiet on solid-state batteries, more focused right now on its upcoming 4680 battery, which is a lithium-ion battery. Now, to overcome the drawback, solid-state battery employs a solid-state electrolyte. The drawback of liquid that can cause explosion and fire. To overcome that, solid-state battery employs a solid-state electrolyte versus liquid electrolyte. Particularly due to the flexible nature of the polymer, the polyelectronic-based all-solid-state battery is stable even in a collision, in a car collision, and has minimal risk of fire as it is inflammable. Moreover, when compared to lithium-ion batteries of a similar size and weight, the energy density is 1.5 to 1.7 times higher and therefore lasts longer. All solid-state batteries, contrary to lithium-ion batteries, contain only an electrode and an electrolyte without a separator between the positive electrode and a negative electrode. The scientists created a new nanostructured electrolyte by controlling the electrostatic interaction in the polymer electrolyte. The researchers synthesized a set of polymer electrolytes with various strengths of electrostatic interactions, employing advanced synthesis methods, and affirmed the nanostructures of these electrolytes by small-angle X-ray scattering profiles. Furthermore, the scientists in Korea analyzed for the first time the distribution of ions with the nanostructures through extensive molecular dynamic simulations. Employing the simulations, the scientists detected the charge distribution at several angstroms and confirmed whether it was a key to create novel three-dimensional low symmetry morphology. The research is one of its kind in the regard of the low symmetry morphology has generally been found in bimetallic compound materials, however unprecedented for the case of polymer electrolytes, and is substantial in that it systematically determines the reason for the creation of these nanostructures through experiments and theoretical calculations. Moreover, friends, this is the first research that indicates a process for fabricating a solid electrolyte processing a conductivity of 10 times higher than that of a two-dimensional morphology by controlling the charge distribution at the A unit level in a polymer electrolyte. Specifically, the research associated between Professor Moonjing Park, who holds a world-leading group in polymer electrolyte synthesis, and Professor Changyo Sun, a specialist in computer symology, developed great synergy. They say the new nanostructure enables a significant enhancement in ionic conductivity compared to the typical two-dimensional structures that have been previously reported. This provides a potential route to accelerate the commercialization of all solid-state batteries and develop safe batteries. The research was carried out with support from the Mid-Korea Research Program, the Creative Materials Discovery Program, the Science Research Center Program, and the Young Research Program in the National Research Foundation of Korea. Speaking of batteries, we're learning that China's CATL, who is a big Tesla battery supplier, looks to raise $9 billion to expand lithium-ion battery production. You see, on one hand, we're learning that the industry wants to move from lithium-ion to solid-state, from lithium electrolytes to solid electrolyte, but CATL is raising, a leading battery supplier, is raising $9 billion to expand lithium-ion battery production. So Reuters is reporting just a couple of days ago that China's CATL said it was planning a private share placement to raise up to 58.2 billion yuan, which is $8.98 billion, to fund six projects aimed at boosting its production capacity of lithium-ion batteries. The massive fundraising comes as the Ningbo-based firm, formerly Contemporary Amperex Technology, expands battery manufacturing capacity around China and in Germany. You remember that recently they moved some production to Germany. Now, it will also be used to build several battery factories in Fujian, Zhejiang, and Guangdong provinces in China, and to boost capital, CATL said in a statement late on Thursday. In addition, it will use the capital to develop battery technology for energy storage facilities. As the global auto industry accelerates transformation towards electrification, CATL is supplying electric vehicle batteries to a swath of automakers, including Tesla, Volkswagen, Geely. It is competing with Japan's Panasonic and South Korea's LG Chem. Now, let me know, friends, what your thoughts are on CATL and also on the research from published in Azo Materials that I said, the research that improves ionic conductivity in solid-state batteries. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news. Ring the bell so you don't miss my next Tesla coverage. Have a great day, everyone. Give us thumbs up, please. Share in social media. I would greatly appreciate that. And I look forward to hearing from you, and God bless you, peace be with all of you, and I'll see you soon.